Good morning, sweet home. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, sweet home. Today is Wednesday, April 29th, 2020. My name's Matt Curley, and here's today's morning announcements. Our principal, Mr. Perry, is here once again with his weekly video.
Good morning, sweet home students. It's Mr. Perry with your weekly message. As we move into the seventh week of our remote learning, I'd like to encourage you to stay the course and keep working hard until the end. Embrace this time, trying not to focus on what it's taken from you, rather what you can learn and improve upon. We are hoping to return on May 15th, but as we know, that is not a guarantee. This week, teachers are proceeding with new instruction. We remind you to do your best with each assignment given to you. Stay engaged and ask for help if it's needed. Your teachers will continue doing whatever it takes to help you be successful during this challenging time. If you see a zero, quickly turning in the work raises your grade. Teachers will continue grading the same way they always have until there is a better understanding of the schedule for the remaining of the year. Enjoy the week and embrace the sweet home way.
Thank you, Mr. Perry. Now we're excited to hear from another high school administrator, Mr. White. Here's Mr. White with a video.
Good morning, Panthers. This is Mr. White. I wanted to take a moment to let you know that during these tough times, each one of you have an army of people in your corner. Please take some time to reach out to and stay connected with your family, friends, teachers, counselors, and administrators. We miss you and are excited for the day we see you again. Keep checking your Schoology and email and stay in touch. We hope to see you soon.
Every day we'll be honoring a different senior in Senior Spotlight. Today is Sarah Hudson. Sarah Hudson is going to attend the University at Buffalo, majoring in dance. Congratulations, Sarah.
Attention all spring sports athletes. Sweet Home Sports Central wants to celebrate your favorite moments from your sport. Send us your favorite photo from your sport, whether it's on the field or court, an action shot, or a great moment with teammates. Feel free to send a sense or two of why you like the photo. We will post them on the Sweet Home Sports Central's Twitter account. Email your photos to Matthew Carlini at carlinim@students.sweethomeschools.org.
Attention juniors, the June 6th SAT has been canceled. Students can register for possible summer administration starting in May. We'll contact students directly during the week of May 26th to provide an exact date. Email your counselor with any questions for more information.
Hey everyone, I'm Michael Torito. Today we honor one of our spring sports teams and its seniors. Here's a shout out to the varsity baseball team. Coach Denman and Coach Campolo would like to congratulate the team and especially the senior class for their dedication over the years with the program. The baseball team and its players are a great example of what the commitment and dedication will do to make a group of individuals come together for a common goal. These experiences gained will make everyone stronger and more prepared for the next steps beyond high school. They will be remembered as champions. Great job, boys.
So I've shared some of my hidden talents with you guys that a lot of you didn't know. So here's a challenge that I have for you. It's your turn to show off your hidden talents. Whether it's singing, cooking, dancing, painting, whatever it may be, I want to see it. Take a short little video of you doing your talent and send it in to us at shhsmorningshow@sweethomeschools.org and you'll be featured on the show. Who's up for the challenge? If you guys have any questions, please feel free to email me at toritom1@students.sweethomeschools.org. We can't wait to see all your talents. Talk to you guys soon.
Our staff wants to celebrate our seniors. Each day, we will show some staff photos from their senior year in high school. Try and guess who the pictures are. Here's more of our staff. Look for more staff senior photos tomorrow. That's all from us today. Hope everyone is safe. For the latest information, go to sweethomeschools.org. Now stay tuned for more announcements. Bye. And now for Media of the Day with Senior Alex Biondo.
Hey, Sweetum. My name's Alex Biondo, and welcome back to another Media of the Day. Today's media, as I said yesterday, is Portal 2. I'll read you a little bit about it. Like the original Portal, players solve puzzles like placing portals and teleporting between them. Portal 2 adds features including tractor beams, lasers, light bridge, and paint-like gels that alter players' movement or allow portals to be placed on any surface. In the single-player campaign, players control Chell, who navigates the Aperture Science Enrichment Center during its reconstruction by the supercomputer GLaDOS. New characters include Robot Wheatley and Aperture founder Cave Johnson. In the new corporate mode, players solve puzzles together as Robot Atlas and Peabody. So there are two versions of Portal 2. There's single player and multiplayer, so you can play it together and solve puzzles with your friends, which is pretty cool. Or you can play the single player like you could see here. And I don't know why there's a squid on the screen, but... this is a really fun game. It's a lot longer than Portal 1. It is $10, just like Portal 1. And you'll have a lot more to do. It goes a lot more into the, the lore in the game, and it's really cool. Just like Portal 1, it's revolutionary to how games are played and made now, and it's just really, really interesting, and I love it so much, and I wish I could experience it all over for the first time again. But I hope you guys like this media, and I will see you guys tomorrow for the next one. Bye!
If you are struggling right now, it is totally normal. Be open to the idea of texting or calling your friends and talking to them about how you feel. Pick someone who you know won't judge you, and if they do, they aren't being a true friend. If you don't feel comfortable talking to one of your friends, there are many other people you can turn to. Emailing a counselor or a teacher may be more beneficial for you. If that doesn't seem to work, then call 1-800-273-8255 or text TALK to 741-741 to talk to a counselor. Using headspace.com/NY can also help you through this tough time. Understand that you are never alone and that there is always going to be someone there for you.
Attention, Sweet Home families. If you are in need of any meals during this time, please know that meals are available at schools and sites within our community. Meals are distributed at Glendale Elementary, Maplemere Elementary, Heritage Heights Elementary, Willow Ridge Elementary, Ready Academy, and the Sweet Home Middle School. Meals are also available at Raintree Island Apartments in front of the playground, Amherst Baptist Church on the corner of Pepper Tree and Willow Ridge, the Sutton Place Apartments near 237 Traverse Boulevard at the intersection of East and West Somerset Lanes, at the intersection of Glenhaven Drive and Vine Lane on the corner of Hartford and Millersport Highway, on Elm Circle and Buckeye Road area, at the corner of Burhaven and Azure Pine Court, and at the North Bailey Fire Department on Sweet Home Road. If you have any questions regarding meals and their availability, contact Sandy Coca, the District Food Service Director, at 716-250-1446 or go to www.sweethomeschools.org for more information.
And now, time for Staying Fit with Mr. Basehart.
Everybody, Coach Basehart here for the Panther workout number 6. Can you believe it's been 6 weeks of this craziness? Well, in any event, I hope you've been working out. There's certainly no better time in the present to start if you haven't. But let me tell you a little bit about this week. For those of you that have trained with me, you're familiar with this 30-second for exercise HIIT. HIIT stands for High Intensity Interval Training. What we're going to do is we're going to train with 30-second intervals, and we have four different movements. So I'm going to take a minute to review these with you and show you a way that you can enhance this. So let me walk a little closer.
Okay.
The first is a squat. I'm going to demonstrate how to do a good body squat. And if you would like, you can add a jump at the end. Now, because of the ceiling height here and my 6-foot frame, jumping is not a real safe thing for me to do. Next, we're going to do mountain climbers. Okay, and again, we're going to do mountain climbers for 30 seconds. Planks. Now, there's many ways to do a plank. There's a 4-point plank. That's elbow, elbow, foot, foot. There's a 3-point plank, 2 elbows and 1 foot. And there's even a 2-point plank where you're balancing on your forearm, 1 elbow, and both feet are stacked. And then finally, there's a burpee, everyone's favorite exercise, right? Burpees for breakfast. Burpees can be done many ways. I'm going to demonstrate how to increase the intensity of the burpee by asking you to maybe add jumping jacks or push-ups or even a little spider move at the bottom, okay? Now, I'm not going to do each move for 30 seconds. I'm just going to demonstrate and walk you through each of the four moves, okay? I would recommend doing this one time, which is a total of 1, 2, 3, 4 exercises for 30 seconds. That's 2 minutes. Resting, 15 to 30 seconds, and then lather, rinse, repeat. The more of these sets you do, the more workout you'll get. There are some athletes who up to 5 to 10 of these resting in between. So if you think about it, if you're working 5 sets for 2 minutes apiece, you're really only working for 2 minutes. Now, it's a pretty intense 2 minutes, so let's get started. The first movement to demonstrate is just a basic squat, okay? So a body squat, you want to do with your arms locked behind your head or in front of you. Some people call that a zombie squat. So I'm going to turn to the side so that you can see the butt and the knees are fairly parallel and are on the same plane. So I'm going to drop down and notice that the butt and the knees are parallel. Then I'm going to rise up. Now, if I decide to do a jump, when I'm down here, I'm going to take my arms back. Now I'm going to extend them up, and as I extend them up, I'm going to pretend I'm flying like a Marvel superhero, okay? That's a squat. You're going to do 30 seconds of squats. Mountain climbers, the second exercise. Okay, I'm going to get down on the hands and knees, and you notice that my back is parallel to the floor. It's not elevated, okay? The back is nice and parallel to the floor. I'm almost forming like a table. Now when I do these, the leg is going to come forward. My right leg is touching my right elbow. The left leg is touching my left elbow. And of course, I want to do these relatively quickly. So this is what a good mountain climber will look like. You'll feel it in the core. You'll feel it in the legs. Next, a plank. I'm going to demonstrate a 4-point plank, 3-point plank, 2-point plank. 1-point plank would be levitating, so let's not even go there. Okay? Here's your first plank. First, elbow, elbow are going to be aligned with my shoulders when I drop to the floor. Elbow, elbow, shoulder. Notice my back is nice and flat. I'm squeezing the glutes to create like a table effect for my back. That's a 4-point plank. Here's a 3-point plank. You notice my feet are stacked one on top of the other. There's less support for my overall body and my muscle chain, so I'm doing more work with my abs and my glutes. This is a 2-point plank, where you're locking one arm behind your back, the other arm is in front of you, okay? So 4, 3, or a 2-point plank for 30 seconds. The final exercise is a burpee, okay? Again, I'm gonna have some difficulty doing it with the height of the ceiling, but I'll do the best I can, okay? A burpee typically begins with a jump. So I'm gonna jump as high as I can without impaling myself on the nails and the floorboards here. So I'm gonna start with a jump. After my jump, I'm gonna drop down to the floor and push my legs back, okay? So that's gonna be my next move. Down to the floor. Push my legs back. Now, I could do a push-up here. Okay? Then I can jump back the top and do a jumping jack, and then lather, rinse, repeat. Let me show you another option to really challenge yourself. After you do your jump and your body is down, you extend your body, you can do what's called the Spider-Man. Okay? When you bring one leg up to an elbow, the other leg up to an elbow, do a push-up, boom, back up for your second burpee. 30 seconds of those. You'll be winded. Remember, 30 seconds, 4 exercises, 2 minutes of work, rest 15 to 30 seconds, lather, rinse, repeat until you can't take any more.